What is going on, guys? I haven't posted a video in so long, it seems like. And it's, I feel like it's time to get back in the groove of YouTube. So I'm here to introduce you to my new project boat that I got for free and side towed it with my personal boat to a boatyard. With that being said, I think us boaters will know free boat is never truly a free boat. Boat stands for bring out another thousand. So it's time to introduce you guys to Wild Goose. She's a 1970 Mark 1 31 Seafarer. So I've just been doing some cleaning right now. She was an abandoned boat, basically, sitting at a marina. And then now she's been sitting underneath this tree. So here is the boat as it sits right now. I'm still cleaning the cockpit from the stern forward. Walk up. She's starting to clean up. I still have a lot of work to do. This boat needs a complete paint job from top to bottom. And that's what I plan on doing. I'm not exactly sure the time frame on this project due to me being on a slight budget. But my main concerns today are getting the topside clean, cleaning up the cabin, which I will show you later on in this video. And I pulled out the side windows that were taped up, and I want to try to get those resealed before the end of the day. And then I can start working on the portholes that are in the boat. They are, I believe, the original portholes, and they're super cool. So I'd like to keep those, but that I think is gonna entail some fiberglass work and things like that. But this is Wild Goose. Give you guys another shot from bow to stern. Walk down this side of the boat. As you can see, maybe not, but maybe you can now, my water bottle is completely empty. So I'm gonna hop down, fill that up, and then run a normal hose up here. I've got the hose. It's got a slight drip, but that'll be all right. Got some tools so I can start cleaning up this caulk around here after I finish cleaning the actual boat. I've got my poker stick for the drains to keep them clear. And the most important, refilled my water bottle. Also found myself some glasses so I don't have to be squinting all day, giving my young eyes cataracts prematurely. But let's get back to work. Enough talking. Yeah, let's close the head door. Not quite ready to go in there just yet. You know, guys, I really should be wearing a mask in here. But I've got the windows off, the compartment way open, or the companion way open, and the front lid hatch also open. But don't be like me, just get a mask. Check out what I just found underneath the V-berth. This is really nice. Extra long flathead and an extra long Phillips head. I don't even think I've seen a screwdriver that long before.
That's nice. Score.
So we are now standing in the V-berth in the forward hatch. Let me show you around. This is really what I have been focused on cleaning today. I did not clean up there, but I did start cleaning all of this right here. The wood walls, bottom of the V-berth. If we come over here, we actually have this built in, and then a mini version of Wild Goose. Coming after the boat. I believe this was supposed to be the galley. You know, shelves here, your sink. This would have been a stove. Right now, there's just a hot plate, a heater, and a bunch of stuff that was left over from the old owner. Do I dare show you all the head? If we can peek into it for a second. But like I said, I haven't cleaned anything in here. Other than the roof, actually, right there. I did a test spot. But the head definitely still needs to be wiped out. Door shuts and latches, which is nice. It's got these beautiful portholes. I'm guessing maybe you can see out, but you can't see in. Oh, wait, no, it's just a mirror. That's a porthole, I guess. That's kind of cool. And then these were the original portholes that I was talking about that I want to reseal as well. Going back to the galley, I don't know if y'all noticed this. Dude actually cut the false wall in between the hull and the interior to fit a microwave here, which that is not immediately leaving, but it's definitely not going to be on this boat for a long time. If we come over here, I guess this would have been like seating, a place to chill, place to hang out. We got built-ins literally all over this boat. On both sides. Most of the latches still work. You got like your mapping table. I ran out of rags. I really want to wipe up that puddle, but I ran out of paper towels. And I'm still trying to do some organization, but this is the dinette. This piece comes up. This foot right here is for that table that is right here. And I've actually never even seen what that table looks like. But yeah, walking back on the top side, I had got the rain channels for the lids cleaned out so they would drain better. I don't know why I'm holding this hose. And I had started scraping all the old caulk out of the window seams. At least I did it on this side. If I can get power over here, that handy dandy shop vac might actually come in hand. I still gotta scrape out the other side and decide what kind of caulk I wanna use, or silicone. Also, I need to refill my water bottle. I'm really trying to pace myself right now, because it's getting warmer and warmer. I'm just trying to get this done. Hope the camera view is good. Well, I'm literally leaning on my tow rail, and then I'm using the pick that I showed y'all earlier to keep the phone up. But I'm just digging away. Little by little. Deck's also starting to get hot. A lot of people in my life think I'm kind of crazy for taking on a boat project of this size, but I want to prove them wrong, so I gotta just keep working on it little by little. Just got some clean rags and my phone charger, but look at this weather we have coming in. I may have put myself in a predicament with taking these windows out today. Y'all probably can't see it, but it's starting to drizzle. Trying to decide if I want to tape up the back side of these windows or not. I think I'm fine for now. What's up, guys? I don't even know where I left off this video. I think it was me showing you the weather, but I went ahead, silicone the windows back in. I left a little bit of access. Once that stuff dries up, I'll scrape the access and then use a new tube of caulk because I ran out of caulk and that was my only one. But I went ahead and taped the back sides of the windows just in case. I know I just freshly sealed it, but there's weather coming. I have my trash bag from everything I've done today, and I think it's about quitting time. I think it's about time to get off the boat for the day. Also, you guys, if you're working in a boatyard, please make sure, you know, whatever you plug in and flip breakers on for, that you unplug and flip the breakers back off for whenever you're done using that power source. Just have one more nice look at it before we get down to end this video. Yeah, you guys haven't even seen the sides or the outside. She's not very pretty from the outside. Like I said, she needs a full paint job. But this is, I guess, the first episode of the Wild Goose Saga. So if you guys have enjoyed this first episode of the Wild Goose Saga, please hit the like button, subscribe. There will be more parts. We will slowly complete this thing one job at a time. As it actually cools off and rain starts to fall, I'm closing out this video. Have a good night, everybody. I know I just closed out the video, but literally, just as I said, it's starting to rain, and it's perfect timing to get out of here. It actually is raining now. Anyways, peace, guys.